Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for being here. My name is Malika and I started this channel to share more about my experiences traveling and living abroad. Thank you so much for stopping by. I'm getting ready to move out of the US for the second time in a few weeks, but today I'm doing a deeper dive into my first time moving abroad, which was when I moved to Italy alone. And the big question, how much did it cost? I have another video with a ton of Q&A on like moving to Italy, finding work, getting a visa, getting settled and all that stuff, but I wanted to do a second video focusing on one of the most important topics, the money. I'm gonna be getting into the cost for the move, a sample monthly budget to live in Italy, and some ways you can make money to support yourself while abroad, so keep watching. I moved to Italy as a student in my 20s and ended up getting a job in Milan after school, so I got to stay and work for a few years. I'm gonna do this budget based on my life in Milan because it's one of the most expensive cities in Italy. So if you're living in another city, you'll probably end up spending less than this. Italy uses euros and the exchange rate the day I'm filming this is $1 equals 82 cents in euros. That means $100 is only about 82 euros, so you do lose some money on the exchange rate, unfortunately. If you're trying to set a budget for further down the road, check the current exchange rate, but also look at how it's fluctuated over the last year or two to give yourself a better idea of what to expect on average. Since currency rates literally change every day, you need to look at some longer data to get like a better budget. So here's an idea of what to expect for life in Milan. This is based on my experience as an expat with a salary job, so I had a little more disposable income than if I were a student or had less stable employment. But you can scale this up or down as needed based on your income. So after taxes, my take-home pay was around 2,000 euros a month, and this is how I spent it. Rent, $500 to $600 a month with a roommate, but you'll spend about $1,000 to $1,300 if you want to live alone. If you want to live alone in a studio or a one-bedroom, you're going to need to budget around 1,000 to 1,300 euros a month, depending on the neighborhood. My salary was just absolutely not gonna let that happen, so I lived with a roommate. I was more focused on the location and the safety of the building, and I got lucky enough to score a room in a great apartment in central Milan, just a few blocks away from the Duomo and like really beautiful neighborhoods. It was a fourth floor walk up and like a really tidy space, but I was paying for the location and it had everything I needed. My roommate was an Italian girl who had the official lease, so the process was really easy for me. My rent was about like $650 a month and that included utilities, but during the winter, I would just chip in more money because she just would refuse to turn the thermostat up because the bills do get pretty expensive, but the apartment was always freezing, like frigid cold in winter. And she also had a weird habit of like opening the windows to smoke, but then she would just leave them open to like cold air in, even though it's the dead of winter. So I wasn't trying to die of hypothermia in my own house, so I just got a space heater and I kept it running in my room, or I would take it into the bathroom when I needed to wash my hair, because you know natural is wash day, it's real. You'd be in the shower for 45 minutes to an hour trying to detangle your hair, and you could not do that in a freezing cold bathroom. Since my space heater habit would drive up the electricity costs, I just chipped in more to help cover it. Utilities are gonna run around 130 to 180 a month, or up to 200 euros depending on the season. If your rent does not include utilities, you should budget between 130 to 200 a month. The biggest variance will be seasonal, like using more heat in the winter or keeping fans running in the summer. Most places don't have AC, so just keep that in mind as well. The utilities should include gas, electricity, Wi-Fi, and there's also a TV tax. I never had a TV in Italy, so I never paid the tax, but I have heard all about it. So if you have a TV, you will get a bill from something called RAI, whether you actually watch local TV or not. If you own a TV, they know you have a TV, you're getting this bill. Groceries were around 100 to 150 a month. I found groceries pretty affordable between the grocery stores and the fresh farmers markets. You can get like a whole bag of pasta for 2 euros. So in a typical week, I'd spend like 20 to 30 euros on groceries, and then once a month, I would go to a specialty store that had a lot of Asian and Indian goods just to mix it up and get some variety. So on those trips, I would probably spend an extra 15 to 20 euro, mostly on spices and sauces, but that would last a few weeks. Dining out, I spent around 100 euros a month. I don't think I ever ordered out, like I just didn't do takeout. And I didn't really do a lot of expensive dinners just because I honestly couldn't afford to. But the main thing I did do a lot was the aperitivo, which is like happy hour, but there's just a ton of free food. Some places, like the little more fancy places, would give you like a little plate of some like prosciutto and then there's some cheese. But the best places would have like a full buffet and you could help yourself all night while you drank. Maybe not all night, like it might be like a couple of hours, but still. So you can go out and have a glass or two of the house wine, which is usually like 5 euros, and then just like load up and go ham on that buffet. That kept my dining expenses down since most of the food was free. It's hard to give you an average restaurant cost since they are all over the place. Like, you can eat at little cheap hole-in-the-wall places, you can grab a 6 euro sandwich from the grab and go at your bar, or you can be like baller status and go out for like 5-star dining restaurants. Like, it's really all over the map. Also, quick note on dining out and groceries, all employees got something called the Boni Pasti, which was like a meal voucher, kind of like food stamps, but everyone got them. So every month, HR would give you this little booklet of them, and you got one for every working day of the month. So weekends and bank holidays weren't counted, but you would get 5 euros every day to use for lunch, and pretty much every restaurant accepted them. And you could also use them in the grocery store. So if your job offers that little benefit, it will definitely come in handy in terms of keeping your food costs down. Phone, 12 euro. My phone bill in Italy was surprisingly cheap, and there were never any like contracts or commitments. I went with Wind, and my SIM card activation fee was around 10 euros, and I think I paid like 12 euros a month for a plan that had unlimited text and data, but the data slowed down a lot after the first gig. Vodafone was another popular option, so you can compare the two. I don't remember why I picked Wind, I just picked Wind and it was fine. Gym membership. I love working out, so not having a gym membership was just simply not an option for me. I cannot remember the name of the exact gym I joined since it was so long ago, but I just did some browsing on current prices, and it looks like a fancy gym like Virgin Active is about 85 to 125 euro a month, depending on your membership level, but most gyms will average around 50 to 75 euros a month. And there's also a lot more independent fitness studios like yoga, Pilates, boxing, like any kind of classes that you want. So you can pick your classes, and also gives you a bonus chance to practice your Italian while you work out. Transportation, 30 euros. Public transportation in Milan was pretty convenient, so I used that a lot. The underground was like a little yuckier than the metro in London or Paris, but I was a big fan of the trams. They were really cute and old-fashioned. They go all around the city. It was 2 euros each way, and a card with 10 fares was 18 euros. Milan's also a very walkable city, so I got around by foot most of the time when the weather was nice. And I was also able to walk to work, so I didn't have a daily commute cost, but I just used the metro for getting around on weekends or after work. So my average spend would be around 30 euros a month on public transportation, not including taxis. Taxis. There was an Uber when I lived in Italy, so your options were either public transportation or a local taxi. The base fare for taxi is around 3 euro, and then it's additional 1 euro 68 cents to 1 euro 12 cents per kilometer. And you also almost always have to go to a taxi stand to get one. If you call a taxi service, they will start running the meter from the time they leave to go pick you up. So it'll already be run up a significant amount by the time you even get in the car. So a short ride wouldn't be that bad depending on how far you're going, but it can add up quickly, especially since you do have to actually walk to go find one. I limited my taxi use a lot, so I'd only take a taxi like at night if I were going out like to a party or something. Travel. So now we're getting to the fun part of my budget. I, generally speaking, tried to keep my miscellaneous spending down so I could have more money to spend on trips, because I was not gonna live in Europe and then miss the chance to actually see Europe. So I gave myself a travel budget of around like $200 to $300 a month, and that usually got me one good weekend trip, or I'd kind of skip it or save a little bit more and then have a bigger one. But Ryanair and EasyJet became my best friends. You could easily find round trip flights for like 50 to 70 euros, and I would usually stay in hostels, but hostels that were considered like expensive for a hostel. So a cheap hostel might be 15 to 20 euros a night for a co-ed dorm of 16 bunk beds and a public bathroom down the hall, and they're disgusting. A private or a semi-private room with an attached bathroom might be closer to 40 or 50 euros a night, so still affordable and well worth the upgrade. I'll leave links to some of my favorite hostels in the description box if you're looking for one that won't be a nightmare. My hostel days are over for sure, but I love the experience. And it was the only way I got to travel as often as I did, especially since I was mostly traveling by myself and had no one to split costs with. Then in August, everyone goes on long vacations, and I traveled for about 3 weeks straight. I think I skipped my monthly June and July trips so I could better plan for the August holiday, and I took like an amazing trip. I started in the south of France, went down to Cinque Terre, and then made my way all the way down to the southern Italy, hanging out in Puglia. Shopping. I'm not really a big shopper. Most people are surprised to hear that I kind of hate shopping. And I was also really lucky that I got to work for this luxury footwear brand, so we got some really generous perks. Plus, I was a sample size, so there were always freebies. My shoe collection got insane. So luckily, I didn't have to spend a lot of money on clothes because I just always had 6 shoes. Other than the occasional like party dress or some like seasonal updates from stores like Zara or H&M or Mango. In the fall and winter, Calzedonia became my favorite. I shopped there like a decent amount because they have really amazing tights, and that could just be the way to spice up a basic outfit. Like, you can wear the same little black dress with different tights, and it's just awesome. There were a lot of the little vintage stores I liked that I would go to for secondhand finds. So I shop more seasonally than frequently. So I might do like 4 trips a year and spend $200 each. So that was like 800 bucks or an average of 66 euros a month. Beauty. I never got any beauty stuff done in Italy, so I can't really comment on those prices. I've always been a fan of doing my own hair and nails, and that I'd have friends send me wigs from the US because you really can't find affordable wigs in Italy. So I'd buy makeup, toiletries, hair products, but not like a lot. Like I bought like a lot of cheap stuff like at Kiko. So that might've been like 20 euros a month on average. Savings. To be honest, after all that, there was none. There was none. I would have loved to be putting money away for the future, for investments, even for like a really long expensive trip not in a hostel, but I just wasn't able to live well and also save on my salary, so I just decided to embrace La Dolce Vita and enjoy my life in Italy while I was there. So whatever money that would have been saved instead went to travel or like occasional shopping. I know it's not the most responsible approach, I know, I don't care. I had a very rare opportunity, so I decided to give myself a break and just let myself enjoy it. So with rent, utilities, groceries, going out, transportation, taxis, travel, shopping, beauty expenses, that brought my monthly budget to around 1,628 euros. As I mentioned before, my monthly income was just around 2,000, so I was living under my max, but still pretty close to it. And that's really not sustainable long-term. But I was young, I was having fun, I wasn't being focused on being frugal or saving, so how to support yourself. I was really lucky to have a salary that let me live very comfortably, but I know that's not the case for most people that just want to move abroad. Most of the Americans I know struggled to find work, and the only options were really teaching English or being a nanny or a babysitter. If you know that type of work is not for you, you may need to rethink your plan to move abroad, or at least delay it until you can boost your savings enough to live off of comfortably without having to earn income or look for remote work that you can do from anywhere. There are so many more remote jobs now than there were before, so it is entirely possible to find something that will let you work from anywhere, so that is an option you can explore. And you can absolutely keep your expenses lower than I did, like have more roommates, live somewhere cheaper, just generally spend less. Do whatever you need to do to have the experience that you want. I definitely did treat myself a little bit and I wanted to have a good quality of life. And one quick note on US taxes. Even if you live abroad, you still have to file a tax return. You will not get out of that. You may not actually have to pay taxes or owe money depending on how much money you made while abroad. So I made well under the limit and I spent more than the required minimum time outside the US. So my foreign income was not actually taxed, but I was still obligated to report it. So make sure you check with your accountant or tax preparer because you do not want to have to pay taxes at the end of the year. And that could end up being a really nasty little surprise if you didn't budget for it. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching, especially if you watched all the way to the end. I'm so happy that you did. It really means a lot to me. If you're thinking about moving to Italy or a new country and have questions about moving abroad in general, just let me know. Happy to answer everything in the comments. And if you like this video, please like, subscribe, and share. Thank you so much.